I'm Willis Conover. Now meet our guest, Marilyn May.
Hi, Willis.
Hi, Marilyn.
Nice to be here.
Nice to have you here. I'm glad that you're up front, because I was looking at the sheet music for your first song, and it stepped to the rear. And, our voice for Vista is Marilyn May. Marilyn, in selecting your material, I know that you have to please yourself, and certainly the employer, and certainly the audience. Preferably all three, and however, your employer and
that's
your
impossible, of course. You know that, don't you?
So you aim for yourself.
Well, no, yeah. No. You aim for what might be right for you, I think.
And for the occasion.
True, true.
For example, now, when you're working in a big club like the Shoreham in Washington, or the Shoreham Blue Room, or the Copacabana in New York,
right?
And you got a big band behind you, does that sort of determine how you're going to sing, the choice of material? And on the other hand, you'll work some other place with a jazz combo.
Oh, yes, definitely, definitely. And the type of club, of course, and the type of audience that you try to psych that out, and so many times you can be very wrong. And sort of in the middle of the show, you feel like, oh, boy, I'm going the wrong direction. And it's much easier to change horses if you're just with a trio. Then with a big band, of course, there's a problem, because music-wise, you know, the arrangements, of course, have to be rehearsed. And you can't really, so when it's more difficult, you don't have the flexibility with a big band that you do with a small trio. But yet, you certainly have that great big marvelous sound going on behind you, and that's really fun for me, and a great deal of push. But I think in setting an act for the floor, I try to do, I've always been a singer that said you should do a lot of variety. And for many years, it seemed to be a problem with people. They said, where's her style? They couldn't find any one type song that I did a lot of, you know.
What do you mean, being versatile?
Well, I always thought that you should do, you know, that's, now they're finding that that's an advantage. And I'm so glad. They say, hey, she can do everything. And I'm so glad, because this is what I worked so hard to learn to do, to try to be able to do the show tune and some jazz and a lush ballad with some emotion and the little up things like we just did, Step to the Rear. I think this is sort of fun for me. I don't get as bored if I did all ballads, and of course I hope it's more fun for the audience.
Well, is there a sort of material that you find you can do for any kind of audience in any kind of setting?
Yes, true. There's a tune, a standard, that Errol Garner wrote, and it's a love song of mine, and I'm sure I get many requests for it even now.
You got one more.
And bless you. Misty.
Marilyn May. Misty by Marilyn May, our voice for Vista. She'll be back in just a moment. Our voice our voice with the frog. Here we go again.
Take that out.
Yeah. Our voice for Vista, Marilyn May. Marilyn, how much of a career just happens, and how much of it can be planned? And then how much happens that makes you change your plan?
All right. First of all, how much just happens? I think a great deal of it. I think you can study for a long time and work for a very long time, and unless you get that big break, forget it. You know, there's no way that it's really going to happen. Also, you can not work. You can work for a week and have an overnight hit record, or be that big act in New York. It's. I really think the breaks. Everybody says to you, "Don't you think it's hard work?" And I said, "Yes, of course it's hard work. You must be ready when the breaks come," and. I am the overnight success that's worked for 20 years, you know, that kind of a thing. So I really think that as far as it's important that you get both, that you have the work and that you're ready when the big break comes.
What did you do to make yourself ready, Marilyn?
Just worked. I've worked all my life. I sang when I was a very little girl, and I did a lot of radio work. And when I got out of high school, I joined a station in Louisville, Kentucky called WHAS, and I was staff vocalist there with a big orchestra. And of course, it was quite a thrill because I was young, and that was in the days when radio had the big lush orchestras, you know, and like they are here, and that's really not anymore, you know. So then I went on the road and worked every Elks Club in Illinois, and went to Florida and worked Florida. I settled in Kansas City. and wound up in a club there with sort of a small intimate club with a trio. And that's, I know about flexibility and material because there we had it. And we had an educated listening audience that really listened to all kinds of music. And it was a great education for me. Steve Allen. I did a local record there, just for local consumption, and it was sent to the major record companies in the hopes that they would buy the master. Really, a songwriter had written some original tunes. It wasn't my showcase. It was more for the tunes. But Steve Allen heard the record through Pacific Jazz Records, and he called. And I all of a sudden found myself on the Steve Allen night show. Remember that old show?
Oh, sure do.
And so we did the show for some time. And I was receiving offers from small record companies. But I figured I didn't want to sign a long-term contract with a small company in case a big company came along. So finally, RCA Victor, on the last show I did before the Steve Allen show went off the air, it was sort of last chance. So that's why I say the breaks, you know. RCA Victor, A&R man, heard me and saw me and called Kansas City and said, I want to record you. And I said, I'll be there tonight. Yeah. That led to the RCA Victor contract.
Yeah, what are you doing right now? That's sort of the answer.
You're right,
I'm sure.
Right. And, of course, since that time, it has changed my life a great deal.
For the better, of course.
Oh, yes, in some ways, and then much more hectic. I'm away from my daughter a great deal now, and I'm not pleased with that, but I'm very pleased with the rooms that we're working now. The caliber of rooms are really fun, and it's fun to meet new people, and it's fun to be recognized after all these years.
Well, now, let's see. RCA Victor has released five long play albums by you so far.
Right. The newest one is A Step to the Rear album.
Would you select another song that you have recorded for that album and sing it for us today?
I'd love to do a song that I really love. It's a brand new song from the new Broadway show Steve and Edie. Steve Lawrence and Edie Gourmet are starring in it. It's called Golden Rainbow, and that's the title tune.
Marilyn May. Now, Charles Wood with Vista Volunteers. Out. Thank you, Charlie, and thanks to our Vista volunteer.
You know, Willis, I do a lot of work for the Seventh Step organization. It's the rehabilitation for ex-convicts, and of course I give what I can give, which is my talent, and I sing at the penitentiaries, and it gives me such a great self-satisfying feeling when I see those smiling faces, and I feel I brought a little bit of light and happiness into their lives. I'm sure this must be what the Vista worker feels when they're contributing to the welfare and help to many of the needy people. It must be a great satisfying thing for them to know that they're really helping that much.
Find out. Write to Vista, V-I-S-T-A, Box C, Washington, D.C. That's a wrap.